Let me start by first thanking the Almighty for providing me with another opportunity to extend Christmas greetings and best wishes for the new year to my constituents, staff members in the Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries, Physical Planning, Natural Resources, and Cooperative, and to the many stakeholders and agricultural organizations I had the opportunity to work with during the past year. This is the time of year where most of us reflect on our accomplishments and also to set our goals for the coming year. This season is also an opportunity for us to offer best wishes to our family, friends, and loved ones. And whilst we are engaged in this exercise of reflection, let's not forget the less fortunate among us. We should also be thankful that in 2019, we did not experience the negative impact of climate change, and we look forward to the coming year with a high level of optimism. We pray that we will continue to be blessed and protected. My call is, let's stay focused on our many plans as we continue to champion and make progress in our respective areas of endeavors. Some of our major projects for the coming year will be the Vegetable Import Substitution Program, the construction of the meat processing facility in Denry, the Agricultural Feeder Road Program, the opening of our National Agricultural Diagnostics Facility, the opening of our Wildlife Educational Center at the Gabriel Charles Forestry Complex, the formal launching of the new marketing entity, the construction of the agricultural complex at Union, the building of our new livestock complex at Volet, and the finalization and presentation of our fisheries policy. To my constituents of Babono, let me first thank you for your continued prayers and words of encouragement. I am grateful for the confidence you have placed in me. I have no doubt that you will provide the support for us to continue the progress we have started. We shall endeavor to continue the many employment programs within the constituency, continue the many social and educational programs in our schools, organizing the many sporting programs that has been providing our youth with an opportunity to display their talent. I will continue discussions with the Youth and Sports Council to identify and implement other sporting activities and programs. As it pertains to infrastructure works in our community, we shall see the improvement to the many community roads under the government road rehabilitation program. Many of our main roads will be resurfaced and a number of agricultural farm roads will be improved. We will continue to work on the expansion of the Gara Cemetery. Whilst the fencing is now complete, in the new year, we will construct a motorable road, toilet facilities, and a proper shelter. We will improve the lighting on the courts in Babono and construct a community hall in Timon. We shall also construct a change room, toilet facility on the Balata playing field and undertake the expansion on the Dibawa field. We shall see improvement to the Lager field and major works on the lighting infrastructure that was neglected. I am happy to inform the parents, teachers, and students for after long meetings, discussions, and renegotiations, we shall see the commencement of the construction of the new school in Lage. To the many farmers occupying agricultural land on the Maki Estate, please be informed that negotiations has commenced for government to purchase the remaining lands for agricultural purposes. My dear constituents, these are some of the many projects for 2020. So let us continue our collaborative effort in working together in the best interests of our beautiful community, Babono. Do not be distracted because many are called, but few are chosen. So as you celebrate, take time to reflect and commit to making the changes in your community. Wishing you an enjoyable Christmas and a prosperous 2020. I thank you.